Bridge, it's Pastor Andy here, and I'm bringing you this morning's devotion. You know, this morning's devotion is kind of a cool one because it's kind of the one where we get to usher in the new year, 2021. It doesn't have quite the same ring as 2020 has to it, but in many ways, we're really hoping 2021 is different than 2020. But you know, as I've been thinking about the new year, I was reminded of a scripture. It comes from the book of Isaiah. And it comes to the people at a time where they're just feeling like everything is terrible. They're in captivity. They're in exile. Everything seems hopeless to them. And the word of the Lord comes to the prophet Isaiah, and this is what he says to the people. He says, "This is what the Lord says." This is Isaiah chapter 43. "He who made a way through the sea, a path through the mighty waters, who drew out the chariots and the horses, the army and the reinforcements together, and lay there, never to rise again, extinguished and snuffed out like a wick." This is how the scripture begins. It's a reminder of what God has done in the past. You see, the people were living in captivity. They were in exile. They were feeling like they weren't in their own lands. And the first thing that the word of the Lord wants to remind them of is what God had done in the past for his people. He had brought them out of Egypt and through the Red Sea. That God is faithful to deliver his people, even when it seems like the last time God acted was a long time ago. What Isaiah wants the people to know is that just because you don't feel like God is up to something right now doesn't mean that he's not there. It goes on, and the word of the Lord says this: "Forget the former things and do not dwell on the past." What he's telling them is not to realize that their circumstances are difficult or not to pretend that it's not real. What he's saying is don't dwell on those things. Don't sit in them. Don't cover yourself with the negativity and the pessimism. Recognize that it's real, but don't dwell in them. Because in verse 19, this is a scripture that everyone knows, Isaiah 43:19, it says this: "See, says the Lord, I'm doing a new thing. Now it springs up. Do you not perceive it? I am making a way in the wilderness and streams in the wasteland." I love the first word of that scripture is to see. What God is calling us to is to be looking for what he's up to be expecting that God is up to something here, even if I don't notice it. I want to encourage you today, as we enter into 2021, to be praying, "God, would you help me to have the eyes to see what you're up to?" Maybe God has been doing something for a while in you and you haven't been noticing it because 2020 has been so stressful or so anxious for you. God says to look for it. He says he's doing a new thing, and some of the new things he's doing is water springing up in the wilderness. He says, "I'm making a way in the wilderness." For the ancient Israelites, a way in the wilderness was the long path back to the promised land from their exile in Babylon. And God says, "I'm going to make a way. I'm going to pave a road for you to walk from a place that you feel like is permanent and dark and terrible, but I'm making a way for you to get back to the promised land." The last thing God says is that he's going to make streams flow in the wasteland, that places that they assume that no life could spring up, that it is only conducive to death and destruction. God says, "I'm going to bring water, the source of life, even to places that you feel like are dead." So I want to just remind you as we head into 2021, I want to leave you with just three things. The first one is this. It's to remember what God has done in the past. Take some time this week to recall how God has been faithful to you in the past. The second thing I want to encourage you to do is this, is don't dwell on what's happened in 2020. That's not to say pretend it didn't exist or pretend that everything was just happy. The key word there is dwell. Don't just sit in it. Don't let it overwhelm you. Don't let it consume you. Recognize it for what it is and move on. And move on to the third thing I want to leave you with is this, that you would pray that God would give you eyes to see the new thing that he is up to in and through you. Blessings to you and Happy New Year from Bridge Community Church. We hope to see you soon.